Yo, what is good, everybody? Welcome to the channel. It is T Ultra here, and we have so much stuff to do in this video. I have over 15 locker codes for you guys, including this Kobe Bryant locker code. You probably already have this card, don't worry. We have plenty of other locker codes, but 2K just made this Kobe Bryant card an evolution card. So we're gonna go over all those locker codes that are currently available in the game. We're also gonna do a little bit of a pack opening with some of the stuff that we get from those locker codes and just other stuff that I've gotten throughout the game recently. And I'm pretty much just gonna go over what I've been doing on my account. Before we do any of that, make sure to subscribe. We are on our way to 200 subscribers on the channel. So that would be greatly appreciated if you could follow along on our 2K journey. And thanks to everyone who is already subscribed. The single player triple threat boards are a little bit juiced right now. As you can see, they have some pretty cool players on there. And the other day, I think it was yesterday actually, I played like somewhere between 8 to 10 games to get to this 500 win Serge Ibaka reward. So along with getting Serge Ibaka, we actually also pulled Dan Issel. We got 10 tokens, I think, 3 times. And I also got the 5K MT vault open prize twice, I believe. There was actually an event where it was like 3 times the MT amount for whenever you opened the vault and got MT. But unfortunately, both times we opened the vault and got 5K, it was outside of like the time range where the event was happening. So that was pretty annoying. But like I said, just really quickly, I'll show you the cards I got. So I got this Dan Issel right here, free Galaxy Opal. He's really not that good. I'm not really going to look at him or anything. And then we also got this Pink Diamond Serge Ibaka. Again, really not that good of a card. He's an evolution card. He goes to a Galaxy Opal. But you see, it's a crazy grind. And even once he's evolved, he's really not that good. But it is still just a cool milestone that we were able to get to 500 wins on Triple Threat. And then along with that, I've just been doing some of these Spotlight Sim challenges. As you can see, we added a bunch of cards. So we're getting a lot closer to getting that Galaxy Opal Kobe Bryant card. It's a little less hype to get the Elder Free Galaxy Opal, even though it is a GOAT card, because you could just do this one without grinding nearly as hard. It's probably not as good as the GOAT Opal, obviously, but it's still really, really cool. So that's pretty much all we've been doing. I also got 5K MT from my most recent wheel spin, and then I did these multiplayer challenges. For one of them, I got 5,250 MT, and the other one, I got 20 tokens, so that was pretty dope. So that is enough of telling you guys what I have been up to for now. I have a little bit more to tell you guys in terms of like what cards I've been buying, all that good stuff later on in the video. But for now, I'm just going to give you guys all the locker codes that are currently available in NBA 2K20 MyTeam, starting with these Players Club locker codes that you see on the screen right here. I'm just going to throw them up for a few seconds each. Feel free to pause the video and enter those in if you have not already. Basically, when you enter them in, it takes you to a ball drop where you drop the ball, you automatically get a pack no matter where you land, and then you open that pack later on and you get a chance at a player. So basically there's like different versions of that player within each pack. Sometimes it's a Galaxy Opal, sometimes it's a diamond, pink diamond, I think there's even an emerald one. So it really just depends on your luck. And also on the ball drops, there are 3 wheels that you can hit where it's like 1 token for each little slot on the wheel. So that's pretty cool too. I'm not gonna show you the ball drops of these Players Club codes because like I said, no matter what, you land in a spot and you get a pack. We will be opening some of those packs later on in this video. Like I said, we're gonna do a little bit of a pack opening. Some of those players, I think 4 of them, I have already opened on video in a previous episode. I think it was Tacko, Justin Wright Foreman, and Bulbul. And then there was also a Lonzo Ball locker code, but that one expired on the 10th. And I believe all of the Players Club locker codes that you are seeing in this video expire on the 20th. So now I'm gonna give you guys some locker codes that are not Players Club codes. They're just other stuff that you can get. And I'm starting with this one right here because this one expires on the 15th. I'm recording this video later in the day on the 14th. So hopefully you see this in time. If not, don't worry. We have plenty of other locker codes to enter in this video. We do land in the Leap Year Deluxe Pack, so we will be opening that pack later on in this video. Here is the next locker code, Flash Packs Drop July. And as you can see on the bottom of the screen, this one expires on July 17th. Okay, and we end up landing in the green. And then here is a locker code. It is Career Highlights Pink Diamonds. This one expires on July 20th. And I'm not actually gonna be doing the ball drop in this video because I already did this ball drop in my most recent Career Highlights Squad Builder video. And when we did it, we actually got Pink Diamond Magic Johnson, which was pretty cool because that was the only one of these players that we did not have already. So that was pretty dope, and he's a pretty cool card. Next up, we have this locker code, EVO Super Packs Return. This code expires on the 21st. And here is what the board is looking like. And guys, you do not want that Larry Hughes card. He was already so cheap. And he's only going to be cheaper after this locker code. So he's probably going to go for barely over discard value. I'm hoping to land in the yellow for the tokens. I would honestly rather get one of those packs. Of course, we get the Larry Hughes. But I was going to say, I would rather get the New Year's Resolution pack than get Larry Hughes. And then finally, I'm just going to throw up on the screen this pink diamond Kobe Bryant locker code. Like I said, he now evolves to a Galaxy Opal. You probably already have this card because this locker code has been out for a long time, but here it is if you don't. This one doesn't really expire, you know. It says it expires on 12/31/21, but in other words, it doesn't expire during 2K20. All right, and I believe that those are all of the locker codes that are currently available in NBA 2K20 MyTeam as of this recording. So we are going to go ahead and open some of these packs right here. We're going to start over here by opening the packs that we got in this video from these locker codes. Start with this flash pack right here, see if we can get anything good. And nothing. We do get a bronze player. That is not what we were hoping for at all. And I'm going to be sending all this stuff to my auction house most likely. If I do run out of space, I'll have to go in there and maybe quick sell some stuff. But for now, we're just going to send it to our auctions. Now we're going to open up this leap year pack. Come on, give me a Galaxy Opal. Give me something good here. And we get a Roby. I wonder who it is. It is Kenneth Faried. Okay. We will send all of that stuff to the auctions. And let's see. Let's try to open some of these players club packs now. See if we can get anything dope. So we're going to start with this Muresan pack. And it looks like we get an Amethyst. I believe that is the worst version of the card that is available in this little pack. I can't remember what the best version of the card that you can get is, but there he is. There's his feet. Gheorghe Muresan. The other version of that card that you can get from this pack is a pink diamond. I just went and checked on Twitter on the little photo. So we didn't get the pink diamond, but whatever. I'm going for collector level, so I will always add another player to my collection. Next, we're going to open up Dylan Windler's pack, and you can get either an Amethyst or a Pink Diamond. So obviously, we're hoping for the Pink Diamond, but we do get the Amethyst. Not really surprised about that. Not sure if this is really a guy that anyone is going to want to be using. I have no idea what this card is looking like at all. But there's his feet, there's his legs, and there he is, Dylan Windler. Eric Paschall is up next, and there are three versions of this card. Let's see what we get. We get the Amethyst, okay. There is also a Galaxy Opal and an Emerald version. So the Emerald would be the worst, obviously. And the Galaxy Opal would be the best. So we got the one right in the middle. I'm not sure how common that Emerald one is to get or the Galaxy Opal, but we get the one right in the middle, so I can't really complain about that. So this one is pretty interesting. Jayson Tatum has two pink diamonds, a diamond, an amethyst, and a Galaxy Opal. So let's see what we get. And of course, we get the worst one. We get the Amethyst. There were five different versions of this card that we could have got. We got the Amethyst, but it is what it is. Let's take a look at him here. Oh, there's his feet. There's his legs. Let's see him. Jayson Tatum. Okay, he's flexing for some reason. There we go. My boy PJ Washington. He has an Emerald, Amethyst, and an Opal. Let's see what we get. We get the Amethyst again. So with Eric Paschall and PJ Washington, there were Emerald cards available. We got the Amethyst version for both of them. Like I said, the Emerald version might actually be more rare than the Amethyst. I really don't know because I feel like most people are getting the Amethyst version of these cards. Maybe I'm wrong. I don't know. But we get the Amethyst, so whatever. All right, Meyers Leonard, I need to see a Galaxy Opal from you, please. And no, we get the Amethyst. Those were the only two versions that you could get, a Galaxy Opal or an Amethyst. So yeah, we get the worst one, but that's okay. There's his feet. There's his socks. And there he is. He's jumping. Okay, there we go. And then this is our last Players Club pack that we're going to open before we open the rest of the packs. Let's see what we get. And we get the Amethyst. The only other version of this card that's available is a pink diamond. So we did not get very lucky with these pulls at all. But realistically, I'm not sure we would have used any of these cards anyways. And there he is, guys. Isaiah Roby. And like I said, we already opened the Tacko Fall pack, the Justin Wright Foreman pack, the Bol Bol pack, and the Lonzo Ball pack. So I don't have anything to open in this video for that. So we're just going to go ahead and open the rest of these packs. These were all packs I got from things like Triple Threat Online mostly. A lot of packs were actually from just daily logins. They've been offering a lot of free packs for just logging in every day. So make sure to pay attention to that because you can get some free packs and get some fire cards like this. A bronze and a silver. Okay. Obviously, nothing too crazy right there, but you never know. You never know what you're gonna get with these packs. Just from logging in, you might get a free Galaxy Opal. This basketball pack that you see right here was from that event where 2K had these basketballs in there. So for some reason, I just saved that. I like to open all my packs on video for you guys. Obviously, we already have this one. If you have been keeping up with my content, you would know that. If not, that's why you should subscribe, because you need to know things like that, like which basketballs I already have and don't have. So we already have that one. We're just going to end up selling that one. Okay, we get an Amethyst in the Campus Legends pack. Let's see who it is. I mean, you know, it's probably not going to be a good card, but it's a little bit more interesting than a Ruby. We get to watch some sort of animation. Is this Eric Paschall? I believe it is. Okay, yo, we got two Amethyst Eric Paschalls in this video. So that's, I don't want to say that that's cool, because it's not really that cool, but it's nothing. It's really not cool or interesting. I got this free agent pack from climbing up the ladder on triple threat single player. So hopefully we get one that we don't already have. Vince Carter. Do we already have him? I don't think we do. Okay, cool. I mean, hey. If you know me, I'm trying to improve my collector level, so that helps. Plus, don't those things quick sell for like 1 MT anyways? So, I mean, it really wouldn't even be worth it if I already had that card as a duplicate to quick sell. That last pack I got from Domination, just a free basketball, because you get one of those when you do the all-time Domination. So yeah, I have not finished Domination yet, but we just added another card to our collection, so we're one step closer to our collector level goals, and we get nothing in that pack right there, unfortunately. I kind of want to see some heat. I don't know about you guys. Let's open this Kawhi Leonard pack. If we get Kawhi Leonard, I'm going to freak out. And it's an Amethyst. Okay, I mean, nothing, not what I was looking for. But let's see who it is, you know? Maybe it'll be something cool. I don't think there's a cool Amethyst that exists in the game. Like, are any of them worth a lot of MT? I don't think so. Who do we get? We get Joel Embiid. I doubt he's worth anything, so okay. That is a major bummer, but it is okay, because even though we haven't gotten any fire poles yet, you know, we will be able to still sell this stuff for at least a little bit of MT. It does add up eventually. And let's see a Shaquille O'Neal. No, not even close. We got Nikola Vucevic and Alan Smagalajek. So, bye. See you guys later. That was not a, that was an L. That was an L pack for sure. Let's get on to the next pack here, 2K. It's been a little bit slow for some reason. I was trying to play a game a little bit earlier, and it just, like, I was playing online triple threat, and man, it was so dang slow, Steven Adams and Brook Lopez. It was so slow. I was about to record an Evolved Brandon Roy video for you guys, and I couldn't even play. Like, it was unplayable. So hopefully that gets fixed. I'm not sure if that's like the servers or if it's my internet or what, but it was really, really annoying. Here we just have a league base pack and nothing too crazy. I don't know if you can really get anything crazy from those packs. So, okay, Terrence Mann. Cool, man. Cool to see ya. All right. Contract pack. This is what you guys are waiting for right here. Let's see three gold contracts. Let's see it. Not even one. Okay. It is what it is. Contracts are kind of tight. Oh my goodness. Yo, we have a lot of contracts for the first time since like the beginning of the year. No way. Yo, why is this taking so long? Is the game going so slow for anyone else either? Did you see how long that took? Let's just put it on DeRozan. That's a card I'm probably going to use until the end of 2K20. So I probably should have put a diamond contract on him a long time ago because he's so good. But, you know, those aren't just abundantly available. They don't just hand those out. And again, this pack is a major, 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 major L. Four things to send to the auction house, though. So that's, you know, a couple KMT. Not going to complain about that. Now, we need some heat check cards. So if I get one that I don't already have, I will be happy with that. Let's see what we get. So we get a Ruby Karl Anthony Towns and a heat check Jalen Brunson. I do already have Jalen Brunson on my squad, I believe. Yes, I do. So that's unfortunate, but you know, with the MT that we get from selling him, we should be able to add another heat check card to our collection so that we can get closer to Dwyane Wade. Let's put this one on Gasol. I mean, I don't really love that card, but I have been using him a little bit as kind of like a bigger center, so I'm not sure. It's really not that serious. Let's open up this spotlight pack here. I mean, geez, are there anything good in these packs? Actually, I shouldn't say that. Some cards do go for a random, like just randomly for a lot of MT. Vinny Johnson, maybe he goes for a little bit. I have no idea, to be honest with you guys. Gold consumable pack. Please just don't be an injury card. It's a contract. I'll take it. Three more packs. So we're going to start with this League Series 2 Deluxe pack. See what we got going on. Two rubies. Okay. That would have been cool like several months ago. But right now, not that cool. But two players. That's, you know, a little bit of MT. We'll go ahead and give that contract to DeRozan before we finish off this pack opening here. Go to the League Deluxe Pack, not the D-League. Let's see, we get an Emerald. Okay, who is it? It is Al Horford. Super duper exciting. Emerald Al Horford. Okay. Do they ever give Al Horford a Galaxy Opal? Speaking of which, I feel like we need a Mo Bamba Galaxy Opal. Wouldn't that be cool? I feel like we need one of those. Like, that'd be sick. We end off the pack opening with an Amethyst. I hope it's Eric Paschall. If we can get three Eric Paschalls in one video, that's probably something no one has ever done. And oh, dang it. Is this who I think it is? Is this Jaleel? Those look like his feet. Yep. It's Jaleel. So from those locker codes and that pack opening and all that stuff, we got a bunch of players, basketballs, jerseys, logos, yada, 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 all that stuff to sell. I think everything in here was from this video, except for these two Patty Mills we got from like a mystery pack opening a while ago. And then this Larry Hughes, yep, this was from the from this video. We got him from that one ball drop. I don't know why he was in there, but he was. I will let you guys know how much this stuff sells for later on in like a different video once I actually sell it. But other than that, before we end off the video, I just want to let you guys know what sort of players I have been buying. So on July 9th, we got this Dennis Rodman for only 4,700 MT. And again, most of the players that you're going to see that I just bought recently are for collector level, not really to use. Reggie Theus we got for 5,550 on the 9th again. And then actually, guys, I got this one for 5,550, I think. And then another one on the 10th, I bought for 6,200 on accident. I did not mean to buy two of those cards. It was just an accident. This Dale Ellis right here, we got for only 4,500 MT. That is actually a very good price for this card. He is very, very good. I made a video of the top pink diamonds to buy during the market crash when those super packs were out for just like the best of 2K20 super packs. And he did make the list. So his price might have changed a little bit since then because I'm not sure if those packs are out anymore, but he's still really good. And then other than that, also on July 10th, we bought these three dudes right here in the Flash 8 set. Kobe White was a little under 2K MT. Cole Anthony was 2K MT. And then Griffith was 4,500 MT. And then we also bought this Moments of the Week. Where is he? Moments of the Week, James Harden, Pink Diamond. And he was going for very cheap. Like, we got him for 5,600 MT. And speaking of Moments of the Week cards, I am planning on selling a bunch of these Moments of the Week cards because some of them are going for an absurd amount of MT for no reason, just because they're rare. So I'm probably going to be selling some of these cards in a future video very, very soon. So make sure to be on the lookout for that because we're going to be making a bunch of MT. And then hopefully we are able to add that pink diamond point guard Giannis because, guys, if you don't know, he was also in my list of top pink diamond values in the game, but he's going for so cheap right now. I mean, even to get him for under 200k is ridiculous, and it looks like he's going closer to 100k than 200k MT, so that's crazy. I mean, look how many of these Giannis cards there are. So we're definitely trying to get this card on our squad. Whew. That was a pretty intense video. We did locker codes, we opened packs, we bought some cards, or I told you what cards I bought. We did all sorts of good stuff in this video, man. We went over the juiced single player triple threat boards. Again, like, I got some good stuff from here, from the vault and all that. Usually I have bad luck with this, but the other day, yesterday, it was going good for me. So I'm not sure if that was just dumb luck or if they juiced the odds. I don't know. But if you want to play some single player triple threat, this might be a good time because it worked out for me. That's going to do it for the video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Please like the video if you enjoyed it. Subscribe if you want to see more. And I'll see you guys later. Peace out.